हेलो डियर चिल्ड्रन, साई राम। वेलकम टू सोशल स्टडीज क्लास। इन टुडेज क्लास वी विल डू रिवीजन ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 5, आवर स्टेट्स। नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, व्यू द इमेज। यस, नाउ इन दिस इमेज यू कैन सी पेरेंट्स आर लुकिंग आफ्टर the needs at home, right? In the same way, the government looks after the needs of the people of the country. Who is the government? A group of people governing or administering people of a country or a state is called the government. Follow children, government means group of people governing or administering. Administering means controlling, managing. Followed, people of a country or a state. The government looks after the needs, welfare and safety of the people of a country. Government also frames laws and rules to run the country. The government decides where to build. Yes, see the first image. What is this image? Yes, this is school, right? School. The government decides where to build school, where to build roads, where to build hospital, where to build public park, where to build the railway station, and where to build the airport. Follow children, government decides to build all these places. Government also provides all these facilities, such as electricity, okay, supply of electricity, supply of water facility, then telephone services and means of communication like computer, radio, telephone, newspaper, cellular, letter, television, magazines, etc. All these are provided by the government. Government takes the responsibility to provide all these amenities, all these facilities. Now, there are two types of government in India. The first one is the central government. Yes, children, already have learned this. And the second one is state government. Followed, the country is run by two types of government. Number one, central government, and number two, state government. Central government looks after the safety and the welfare of the whole country. Follow children, who looks after the safety and welfare of the whole country? The central government. The central government is based at New Delhi. Okay, New Delhi. I'm just underlining the word. New Delhi. New Delhi is the capital of India, our country. Followed, New Delhi is the capital of India. See, it is given in the map. You can see here. This is New Delhi. Followed? Now children, who choose the members of central government? You can see many people. Yes. So many people are there. More than 100 crores people are there in India. It ranks second. Yes, population-wise, India ranks second in the world. So, who choose the members of central government? People. Okay, we the people. People choose the members of the central government. People. Who are the members of the central government? Yes, the president, the prime minister, and other ministers are the members of the central government. Who is the president of India, children? Mr. Ramnath Kovind. See, the image is given. You can view the image. Yes, who is the Prime Minister of India? Mr. Narendra Modi. And in the third picture, you can see so many ministers are sitting together, right? And they are discussing about something, right? They are doing meeting. So all these members form the central government. Now view this image. All these members are the member of the central government. The members of the central government live and work in New Delhi. New Delhi is the capital of India. View this image. This image is also given in your textbook. This is the Parliament House in New Delhi. Parliament House is located in New Delhi. Is a seat of the central government. Okay, children, where all the members of the central government are allowed to sit in the Parliament House for meeting, for conducting meetings. The President of India lives in Rashtrapati Bhavan. This is the Rashtrapati Bhavan wherein the President of India, who is the President of India? Mr. Ramnath Kovind. So Mr. Ramnath Kovind lives in Rashtrapati Bhavan. Now view this picture. So many people are there in this picture, right? This is the population of India. India is a very big country with a population of more than 100 crore. It is difficult for the central government to take care, to look after the needs of such a big population all by itself. As it is difficult for the central government to look after the needs of the people of the whole country, so the country is therefore divided into smaller parts or states. Each state has its own government, which looks after the welfare of the people of that state. Follow, children. Each state, see, there are so many states. Each state, see here, state of Rajasthan, state of Gujarat, state of Maharashtra, state of Madhya Pradesh, state of Chhattisgarh. So each state has its own government, which looks after the welfare of the people of that state. There are 28 states in our country. How many states are there? There are 28 states in our country. Every state has its own capital and its own government. Followed, every state has its own capital. For example, Rajasthan, the capital of Rajasthan is Jaipur. गुजरात, द कैपिटल ऑफ गुजरात इज गांधीनगर. महाराष्ट्र, द कैपिटल ऑफ महाराष्ट्र इज मुंबई. इन दिस वे एवरी स्टेट हैज इट्स ओन कैपिटल एंड इट्स ओन गवर्नमेंट. फॉलोड? वी हैव ऑलरेडी रिवाइज्ड द मेंबर्स ऑफ द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट. मेंबर्स ऑफ द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट. नाउ हु आर द मेंबर्स ऑफ द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट? यस चिल्ड्रन, इट इज ऑलरेडी गिवन हियर. ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड. द गवर्नर, द चीफ मिनिस्टर एंड द अदर मिनिस्टर्स एंड सीनियर गवर्नमेंट ऑफिसर्स. Follow children, the governor, the chief minister, other ministers and senior government officers form the members of the state government. All the members together run the government of the state. They, all of them together, they run the government of the state. They look after the welfare of the people of the state. Follow children, they look after the welfare of the people of the state, or you can say they look after the needs of the people of the state, of the individual state, not the whole country. Okay, there is a difference. Okay, not the whole country, only the state, only a particular state. Where do the governor and chief minister live? They live in the state capital. Where do they live? They live in the state capital. Okay, the governor and the chief minister. For example, if we talk about Maharashtra, the governor of Maharashtra and the chief minister of Maharashtra, they live in Mumbai. Mumbai is the capital of Maharashtra. Followed, children? I explained you with the help of example. I hope you have understood. Now you have already learnt about union territories, right? Now union territories under central government. Union territories are controlled by the central government. They are managed by the central government. Besides the states, already we have learnt, right? How many states are there, children? 28 states, right? Besides the states, there are 8 small areas directly under the central government. They are looked after by the central government. They are known as union territories. I hope you have understood the meaning of union territories. Among the union territories, the Andaman and Nicobar Islands are the biggest and Lakshadweep the smallest. Followed, the biggest union territory is the Andaman and Nicobar Islands, and the smallest union territory is Lakshadweep Islands. Now children, let us revise the names of the union territories. Ladakh. You can see this green part. Yes, this is Ladakh. The capital is Leh. Jammu and Kashmir, union territory. The capital is Srinagar. Chandigarh. The capital is also Chandigarh. And Chandigarh is also the capital of Punjab and Haryana. It is the common capital, and Chandigarh itself is a union territory. Then comes Delhi. Delhi is also known as the national capital, and the capital is New Delhi. followed children. The capital is New Delhi. Delhi is called as National Capital Territory. Then comes, here we have done four, Ladakh, Jammu Kashmir, Chandigarh, Delhi. Okay, this is the fifth one, Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu. The capital is Daman. Followed, the capital is Daman. This is combined. Okay, this is termed as single union territory, Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu. Fifth one. Then sixth one is Puducherry. The capital of Puducherry is also Puducherry. Then seventh one, Lakshadweep. The capital of Lakshadweep is Kavarati. This is the smallest union territory of India. Then the eighth one is Andaman and Nicobar Islands. The capital is Port Blair. Andaman and Nicobar Islands, okay, this is the biggest union territory of India. Followed, children? Now, children, already we have revised the names of the union territories. Let us revise the names of the states. Himachal Pradesh, Shimla, Uttarakhand, Dehradun, Punjab, Chandigarh, Haryana, the capital is also Chandigarh, Uttar Pradesh, the capital is Lucknow, Bihar, Patna, Sikkim, Gangtok, Assam, Dispur, Arunachal Pradesh, Itanagar, Meghalaya, Shillong, Nagaland, Kohima, Manipur, Imphal, Mizoram, Aizwal, Tripura, Agartala, Rajasthan, Jaipur, Uttar Pradesh, Lucknow, Bihar, Patna, Gujarat, Gandhinagar, Madhya Pradesh, Bhopal, Jharkhand, Ranchi, West Bengal, Kolkata. Let us do the remaining part. Gujarat, Gandhinagar, Madhya Pradesh, Bhopal, Jharkhand, Ranchi, West Bengal, Kolkata, Maharashtra, Mumbai, Goa, Panaji. Goa is the smallest state of India. Karnataka, Bangalore, Kerala, Tiruvananthapuram, Tamil Nadu, Chennai, Andhra Pradesh, Amravati, Telangana, Hyderabad, Odisha, Bhubaneswar, Chhattisgarh, Raipur. Now, children, let us revise the key points. Number one, India has a population of more than 100 crores. The central government looks after the whole country. India has 28 states and 8 union territories. Each state has its own government which looks after the people of that state. Delhi is known as the National Capital Territory. Now, these are the terms that you have to remember. Government, a group of people governing or administering a country or state. The state government means government elected to administer a state. Central government, government elected to govern a whole country. Welfare, well-being of a person or group. Union territory, area looked after by the central government. This is very important. Though we may live in different states, there is one bond we all share. We are all Indians. We are all Indians. We should be proud of our country and our state. And of course, the Union territories. Now, children, today we have completed revision of chapter number 5, our state. Now start preparing for essay 1 exam. Start learning. Thank you, children. See you in the next class.